Okay, one of the greatest wrestlers of all times is ready to make a comeback, and this man is more determined than ever. And all attention hotline fans, this ex-champion is still big news in the wrestling world as he prepares himself for a potential battle, if you will, with the former Four Horsemen. This could be the biggest uphill battle, as a matter of fact, in history for this great legend. I talked to the man himself as he prepares to get back into the ring. His comments to me were off the record and exclusive to our hotline report. I can't talk about it on the air, but I will give you the inside story tonight during my exclusive hotline report at 1-900-909-9900. That number again, 1-900-909-9900. Folks, call the hotline right now. 5:05 here tomorrow afternoon. It's WCW Pro on TBS. Tomorrow, great world championship action. 5:05 on TBS on the Pro. Right now, let's get you back to the ring.
Okay, Mean Gene Okerlund, thank you very much. Still more great action to come. We still have Lex Luger and Scott Norton of the NWO. And based on the frame of mind of the New World Order Monday, after the Macho Man was carted off to the hospital, it may be a very difficult night for Lex Luger. Let me also say this to many wrestling fans out there who've been watching our programs for years. You may have been appalled by the tone of voice that I used to call the injury to the Macho Man Randy Savage. Injuries are not funny, but they are a part of wrestling. Anytime someone gets hurt, I feel for that person. But based on what had happened to WCW, as you look at Fitz Finlay and his return to the States here, based on what had happened to WCW over the past year, I think you can identify with where I was coming from.
You don't have to ever apologize for anything you say.
Well, I thought about that long and hard, though. You know what I'm saying?
I know you haven't. You put a lot into it, and you thought about it. You are here to do what you do, and you do it better than anybody else anywhere in any of this so-called world of sports that goes on out there and anything. But let me tell you something that happened. You get emotionally involved, and I like that. You have to have emotions sometimes. Emotions drive people. And emotionally, when you seen them get back at Savage after all that's been done to us, you played with emotion. And you're going to see guys play with emotion at Halloween Havoc. I like your emotion. Don't apologize to nobody. That's just my opinion.
And Dave Taylor, well, let me also add to this, and a good maneuver, one, two, because I love good sportsmanship. I love good one-on-one competition. But I had a chance to do an interview on a radio station in Tampa, Florida, not too long ago, and a couple of guys asked me, they say, what do you think Flair needs to do now against Curt Hennig? And this was before Flair made his comeback Monday on Nitro.
Right.
And you think he wants to get Hennig in the ring? I said, what Flair needs to do is this. He needs to jump Curt Hennig from behind when he's walking out of his car and put him in the hospital. And then go in the hospital, and as he's laying in the hospital bed, drag him out, bump his head on the floor, and drag him down a couple flights of steps.
Man.
And then tape something to him that says WCW was here and leaves. That's the type of fighting you got to do when you're going up against a bunch of childish guys like members of the NWO.
Don't adjust your sets. Yes, they haven't driven my companion crazy. And now have that. That adrenaline flowing that needs to be flowing at WCW, or we all might not have a job come next January if this thing is not done and settled. I like it. I'm telling you, drag him out and his head bouncing on the hospital floor. Oh, my goodness. My mom is listening to this. That's all right. She's heard me say words.
This has transcended matches.
Yeah.
It's gotten into a personal fight.
And this is a personal fight between these two guys right here.
It really
is. Finlay back. In the States, as you said, and Dave Taylor and Fitz Finlay has been known to go off a little bit too and play with emotion.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
We saw what he did on an uncensored event a couple of years ago to the face of Steve Regal.
Cool. That's a tater right there, boy. He got him good right under the chop.
Dave Taylor gets forearm shot from Fitz Finlay and goes crashing to the mat. Finlay with a short elbow drop and a cover. One, two. Notice what he does. Takes the forearm and grinds it into the side of the face when he's making the three count.
Well, you go ahead and do a study of all the European wrestlers that come over. Somebody over here at the power plant, the young guys are watching this thing right here. They need to maybe pick this up because all of the Europeans do this, and it's an opportunity that really rags you and gets your jaw all out of whack. And, man, that hurt right there. So they are very fundamental and sound in what they do. This guy right here can be a tiger, can be a mean man. He also can have bad intentions. Diamond Dallas Page, able to overcome so much adversity. Cannot make a mistake with this guy. I'm talking about the Macho Man Randy Savage. You got him wounded, go ahead, put him away. That's the bottom line. Survive.
Got a two count only, as you saw from referee Mickey J. Dave Taylor back up to a wrist lock now on Finlay. Wow. Tell you, Dream. A lot of emotions.
Yes.
You're right.
And you got it. You showed
and
it.
And I have a lot of emotions.
And I think that's what needs to happen. And I think that is going to be shown at Halloween Havoc. I really do, Tony. Nobody likes to see anybody just continually to get roughshod over. You know what I mean? They don't. Not after, I don't care what they say. Well, you know, there's 1,000 guys out there, maybe, as we watch this unusual hole right here that'll tear your neck off. But that's about 1,000 people or 500 people or whatever they are, and they all got an opinion, and they all get together, and they write these letters and stuff about things that happen. But, guys, let me tell you something. You ain't put on a pair of tights. You never paid your dues. You never called matches in a hot, sweaty building. And you're only going by instinct of what you might think it ought to be like. And let me tell you what it's really like. What it's really like is survival of the fittest. Dog eat dog, getting down on it, and getting, Tony, this is it, and I'll stop filibustering, emotional. If you don't get emotional, go find another game, or be a writer. Be a writer. Be a wrestling writer, a sports writer or something. Be a writer. That's good. You don't have to get dirty and sweaty and bloody. You know what I mean? You don't have to get in the battle.
Yeah, you know, the
old coward yourself out. That's what it's all
roll
about.
Roll up 1, 2. You know, what we always say, you know, everyone learned to write it the third grade, and then it was downhill from there.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Exactly. I've seen you in the sweatiest building, standing in the heat of battling and been in there for many years, and you're still a young man. That's not putting you over anymore. I'm just saying, emotional night is coming at Halloween Havoc. Make no mistake about it. It's going to be emotional for Hollywood Hulk Hogan and Roddy Piper. Fit Finlay now has become emotional right here on Dave Taylor.
Fit Finlay.
Man, I hope the legendary Larry Zbysko don't get hurt in this thing. You know what I mean? He's been out playing golf so much, but I'll tell you one thing about it.
What's that?
He will be raped.
He really will. Fit Finlay puts him down with a tombstone pile driver of the 1-2-3. Fit Finlay.
Welcome back. Yeah.
Comes back with a vengeance. He is one of the toughest stars internationally that you will find anywhere.
I wonder what he thinks of Bill Goldberg.
Watch again.
Very handsome man, too. I can't tell you. Well, we take a look at it right here. Fit Finlay and Dave Taylor, we talked a lot during this match about what is going on and the emotional roller coaster that we are on. But right here, picked him up, Paul Driver, gets the 1-2-3.